The kicking team out for Miami as they will send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. To throw right away is Vic. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to upload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Vic with the incompletion on first down, and now that leads to second and 10. There's Michael Vick. And that's going to be incomplete.
And that might have been a situation where even though you don't hit on the deep throw, you at least put in the defenders' minds early in the game that we're going to press the ball deep against your secondary. And that can have a ripple effect on how they function throughout.
So now an early third and 10 here on their opening drive. Vic readies to throw. Looking downfield for Jones. And that's caught inside the 35. A big play there for LA. 54 yards.
It's early, but it now took a cliche alert here. Big players make big plays. Should I say in big games, too? Oh, what the heck. And this defense, they're going to have to find some way to slow him down as this game goes on, because when this combination is going good, they can tear your secondary apart.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Second and a couple. They'll run it for the first time with Williams. And they work this near the five. He'll be stopped at the six. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. They've taken this opening kickoff and marched it right down the field defensively. Not much resistance.
And that's the point, because my admiration is for the guys moving the ball right.
And this is caught. He's got a touchdown. Darius Heyward Bay. 6 yards away. And the Chargers will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. The extra point up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kick unit on here for the Chargers as they will send this one away. On the return, Jalen Waddle from his end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And that incomplete to Clayton. They wind up getting 7 on the play. And it'll be second down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown in the opening drive.
Based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. The discussion we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time, either equal or try and get us ahead and try to keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown game.
And off to the races, down the right side. Inside the 20, and he's going to be out of bounds all the way down inside the 15. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Pressure down it goes. Sacked at the 10. And he
search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
On third down, it dropped a throw. Under pressure, and they got to him again. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Turn here from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Charger drive about to get going.
For this offense, Charles, remember the last time they were out here, marched it nearly the full length of the football field, and a lot of the attack went through the air, so now they're seeing if they can duplicate that performance.
I can't put you on the edge a little bit, because I can hear my high school coach John Ford, and his voice in my head.
Ready!
When you put the ball in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad. But the way the game's being played now, this is just part of what they do, so I don't think they should change anything at all. They've been dominant. Keep throwing it around.
They'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
I'm not quite sure what he thought he saw there, but the reality was certainly a much different picture than what he anticipated. And give credit to the defense. They were down on the flash when he broke out of there, and they forced him out with almost nothing to show for his efforts.
The throw on second down from Vic, incomplete.
Look like both sides were anticipating a quick throw there, and the defense was ready to jump in and deny it, and they did.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. This one swung out to Williams. And he's going to get this to the 41, but that is still well short of what he needed. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tacklers. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter.
Ready,
so they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it here. And able to find the open man. That's complete. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Curious decision to go for it, but it pays off for the first down. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try to keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball. But he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
And Vic's throw there, incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. To throw, Vic.
after the catch and pick up a first down. Weren't able to do so on that play.
Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts. So as they talk it over, we step aside. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They're going to try and throw. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Rashawn Jones. And the Dolphins are going to take over at their own 30-yard line.
Partner, when you're playing cover two, this is like a tag team for the safeties. Each of them gets a half-field responsibility. Their job, stay as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, read the football, and go make a play. In this case, the free safety made the best play, an interception.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Manziel. Theme in this first half. This is second and long. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Looking outside, he's got a man. That's Brown. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 42. Now Manziel. Flush to his right. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down. Here's Manziel. Touchdown. A great effort there. 39 yards. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 14-7. The kicking team out for Miami as they will send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
Here we go, here we go.
The Charger drive about to get going. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula to get them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
He's going to air one out. This is taken in. It's complete. A big play there for L.A. 45 yards.
I'm pretty sure any quarterback will tell you it's nice to have a tight end that can stretch the field. And how about him right there working in the heart of the defense? And they connect on a very nice play downfield. A combination of talent and toughness to go into the Briar Patch.
And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
That throw by Vic, incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving them a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and it seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
19 Tiger.
Now here's Vic. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted.